royal kingdom. A gift of wondrous shapes and sounds that the princess had never seen or heard before. Princess Jasmine felt her heart beat faster, and Aladdin, trying to appear cool, wondered if this royal princess could have feelings of love for him as he suddenly felt for her.
This looks pretty amazing, huh?
Oh, it's wonderful.
I wonder what it'd be like to live there. Have servants, valets.
Oh, sure. People who tell you where to go and how to dress.
That's better than here. You're always scraping for food and ducking the guards.
You're not free to make your own choices.
Sometimes you feel so...
You're just...
trapped.
Yes, yes, I'll tell them, Abu. Listen carefully now. For now it's time to reveal the sinister twists and turns of the villain of Agrabah, the Sultan's chief advisor, the nefarious Jafar. Most certainly, Abu. You must excuse Abu. He gets a little apprehensive during this part, and who can blame him? See, it was Jafar who found Aladdin with the princess and had him thrown into prison. There, in the dampness and the spider webs, disguised as a kindly old beggar, Jafar said to the boy,
"You're only a fool if you give up, boy."
"Who are you?"
"A lowly prisoner like yourself. But together, perhaps we can be more."
"I'm listening."
"There is a cave, boy. A cave of wonders, filled with treasures beyond your wildest dreams. Treasure enough to impress even your princess, I'd wager."
"Jafar, can you hurry up? I'm dying in here."
"But the law says that only a prince can..."
"You've heard of the golden rule, haven't you? Whoever has the gold makes the rules."
"So why would you share all this wonderful treasure with me?"
"I need a young pair of legs and a strong back to go in after it."
One problem. It's out there. We're in here.
Things aren't always what they seem.
Of course, Aladdin agreed. And soon he found himself standing at the entrance to the Cave of Wonders.
"Disturbs my slumber."
"It is I, Aladdin."
"Proceed. Touch nothing but the lamp."
"Remember, boy, first fetch me the lamp, and then you shall have your reward."
"Come on, Abu."
Thank you.
Would you look at that? Just a handful of this stuff would make me richer than the Sultan. Abu! Don't touch anything. We gotta find that lamp. Don't go. Maybe you can help us. See, we're trying to find this lamp. I think he knows where it is.
Here. Up here. Higher. Higher. Up, 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 up. Ah, there we are. Just getting a bit comfortable. Now. Come closer, because the next part of the story, I must admit, is one of my favorite parts because of the magic lamp. Watch this. Well, one keeps hoping. But Aladdin's lamp, on the other hand, was the real thing. You see, with just one small rub of his lamp, Aladdin's life would be changed just like that.
Why, you hairy little thief. Looks like such a beat-up, worthless piece of junk. Hey, I think there's something written here, but it's hard to make out.
Hey! 10,000 years will give you such a crick in the neck.
When I bump a head, them 40 thieves, Sharon's already had 1,000 tales. Master, you in luck, cause up your sleeves, you got a brand of magic never fails. Ammunition in your can. You got some punch, kazam! Yahoo and how? See, all you gotta do is rub that lamp. And I'll say,
Mr. Aladdin, sir, what will your pleasure be?
Let me take your model, jot it down.
You ain't never had a friend like me.
Life is your restaurant, and
I'm your maitre
d'. Come on, whisper what it is you want. You ain't never had a friend like me.
Yes, sir, we pride ourselves on serving.
You're the boss, the king, the Shah.
Say what you wish, it's yours, true dish. About a little more baklava. Pass on my column in. They're all a column in. I'm in the mood to help you, dude. You ain't never had a friend like me. Oh my. No, no. Can your friends do this? Can your friends do that? Can your friends pull this out their little hand? Can your friends go, woo!
Hey, looky here.
Can your
your friends go abracadabra, let it rip, and then make the sucker disappear.
So just sit there like your buggy eyed. I'm here to answer all your midnight prayers. You got me bona fide certified. You got a genie for a charge of hell. I got a power to help you out. So what you wish, I really want to know. You got a list that's 3 miles long, no doubt. Well, all you gotta do is rub like so. Mr. Aladdin, sir, have a wish or two or three. I'm on the job,
you big lay bob.
You ain't never had a friend, never had a friend.
You ain't never had a friend, never had a friend.
You ain't never had a friend, never had a friend.
You ain't never had a friend, never had a friend.
You ain't never had a friend.
As you recall, we left our young lovers in a bit of a quandary. Aladdin with his new friend, the genie, puzzled over his gift of 3 wishes. And Princess Jasmine wondered how she'd ever again find the boy from the marketplace. Then, thinking himself not worthy enough to be loved by a real princess, Aladdin made his first wish.
Hey, can you make me a prince?
Oh, let's see.
Chicken a la king?
No, see, Alaskan king crab. Ow. I hate when I do that. Caesar salad.
Et tu, Brute?
Nope. Aha. To make a prince.
Now, is that an official wish?
Say the magic words.
Genie, I wish for you to make me a prince.
Hang on to your turban, kid. We're gonna make you a star.